हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज सुमित एंड आई वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू टू बीएसपी सेल्फ लर्निंग वीडियो ब्रॉडकास्ट सीरीज। दिस इज माय थर्ड ट्यूटोरियल इन पाइथन फॉर द बिगनर्स। इन माय प्रीवियस वीडियोस आई हैव टोल्ड यू हाउ टू सेट अप पाइथन ऑन अ सिस्टम एंड हाउ टू राइट अ बेसिक सिंटैक्स इन पाइथन। इन दिस ट्यूटोरियल आई विल बी गोइंग टू टेल यू अबाउट हाउ टू राइट अ बेसिक कंडीशनल सिंटैक्स फॉर बिगनर्स। So let's start working on that. So for this, I'm going to open this existing file. So let me open that file which we have created earlier. That's the same file which we have created earlier. This was the file, and it will print simple my name. If I execute it, if I test this, it will ask my name and it will say Sumit. Now, same program I would like to convert into conditional statement, and my requirement is that if the name is okay, if the user enter name Sumit, I want to display a message, welcome message. So I write here if condition, if my name, I test the condition, if the my name user enter input as a Sumit, and it will print welcome and test this. So I enter the name Sumit and I'll got a message welcome. Because as you can see here, if you see this program, first of all I have print a message welcome to BISP solutions self-learning video series. So we are getting this message here. Later on we are getting input from the user, enter your name. So user, whatever name user will input, that will store into my name, and then I am testing the value in the name, my name variable basically. So in this name I test it, it's a comparison operator. So I'm testing if the value in this my name is Sumit, then it will display a message welcome. But if I run this program again, and this time I enter something else like Bob, B-O-B, Bob, I did not get any message here. Why I'm not getting any message here? Because we have test the condition for Sumit. So in order to print another message, if this condition does not satisfy, I would like to print another message, some other message. So for that I use here else and I write a message print by and run program again. This time if I enter Sumit, I got a message welcome, and if I again execute it, this time I enter Bob, I enter message bye. So now you can see here, if this condition satisfy, it will print this message. If this condition does not satisfy, it will go to else and print the else condition, else statement. If we want to check two conditions, I want to check two names. If this condition does not satisfy, I want to test another condition. So for that, I'm going to use here elif. Elif is like else if. And then again, I check my name is equal to, if it is Jack, so I would like to print a message, good boy. And let's test this program again. So double equal, because it's a comparison. So now this time if I'll print a if I enter name Sumit, I got a message welcome. Again if I execute it, and again I enter a name here, if I enter a name Bob, I got a message bye. And again if I execute this, and if I enter a name Jack, I'll got a message good boy. So you can see here what is happening here. First, whenever we enter a whenever user input a name, the name stored into my name, it tests the first condition. If the first condition does not satisfy, it check the second condition. If the second condition satisfied, it print the statement associated with this condition. Else it will go to the last condition and it will print the statement which is associated with else. So in this case, because I entered Jack here, so this condition is satisfied and it print a message good boy. So this is this string. If I'll change this program, and instead of this program, let me create a new program. So I create a new one and close this one, and this time I entered here my var is equal to input enter a number. I would like to test the condition number. So enter a number and I write check if my var greater than equal to 20, print greater than 20, elif. I want to test multiple conditions, so I write my var less than 20 and I use AND operator here. AND operator is used to check two conditions together. Basically, in a single statement we can have two conditions. So I write my var is greater than equal to 10, print greater than 10 and less than 20, else print less than 10. Now if I test this program, first of all let me save this program. So I save it in the same directory, program 2, and when I test this, when I input a number, I'll got an error message. Why I'm getting this error message? Because when user input a number here, that number will not be in the integer format. That number data type will be string type. And we are testing here, we are doing the comparison with the numeric number or the integer number. So that's why we are getting this error. So what we need to do is we need to convert the input into integer. Then only we can do the comparison, or we can work with these conditions. So how to convert an input into an integer? So here I write integer. And simple this. So what will happen here? Whatever user will input, that will transform into integer, that will convert into integer. Now let's test this. Press F5 and I enter a number 45. I got a message greater than 20. And again, if I execute this, run and I enter 5, I got a message less than 10. And this time again I run it, and this time I enter number 15. So I'll get a message greater than 10 and less than 20. Because here, so here you can see when I enter 15 here, when I input 15, so 15 is not greater than equal to 20, 15 greater than equal to 20. So this condition is not satisfied. Then it checks the second condition. In second condition, first step, 15 is less than 20, right? And 15 is greater than equal to 10. So this end condition, basically this end operator, it will test both the condition. And if both the condition are satisfied, then only this statement will execute. Otherwise, the statement will not execute. So this is how we can write a basic conditional syntaxes in Python. I hope this tutorial will help you to understand about the basic conditional statements in Python. If you like our videos, please subscribe on our YouTube channel, or you can visit our website for training program of Python. If you have any queries, you can visit our website and you can write questions to us. That's all in this tutorial. Have a nice day ahead. Goodbye.